We're back after a much needed break. I think the best thing to do now is to do a quick test. See how much. Okay, we're coming up on the dark side here, so I'm gonna take advantage of this last bit of sunlight and test to see how much power we can get out of this thing. Anyway, we got a whopping 60 Gigantor solar panels mounted on this contraption. Each of them is pushing out about 17 kilowatts right now. Let's start it up. Hey, not bad at all. It's pushing out almost 1 megawatt. Just from low carbon orbit, so we should be hitting quite a lot when we get this thing closer towards the sun. Nice. This is promising. Once we get towards the sun, each panel will easily kick out, I don't know, a few hundred. I think 300 or 400 kilowatts of power each. Anyway, let's put these things back in. Deactivate transmitter. All right. I guess I don't want to work in the night. There's no lights on this thing. I'm going to fast forward to the daylight side again. And continue. Finish setting up this spacecraft for its first voyage. It's going to be quite a sight to see if everything works out as planned. Well, we're back on the day side here. Ando is ready to get back to work. So what we need to do now is, well, let's attach the radiators. It's going to be 4 of them. It's just there to help dissipate the heat from picked up by these microwave receivers. Already got 4 up there. Those are just to help dissipate the heat from the solar panels, because once they get really close to the sun, they do pick up a lot of waste heat. Fortunately, it doesn't affect their efficiency, which is good. Anyway, I want to attach this to set. Right? No. Need this higher up. Let's stick this. Well, I guess I'll have to do this in 3s, which means it's going to have to sit on the science can. I think it's okay. Won't interfere with anything. Because I don't want this to get in the way of the cables. I don't think they will, but just in case. That looks about right. A little bit higher. Right there. Okay, good. First one down. 2 more to go. And just remember, if you want to do this yourself, you have to edit the config files for these radiators. So it's very simple. Just open up one of the KAS, Kerbal Attachment System, config files and copy and paste the attach module into the config file for these small radiators. super light, so. What's his retrofit option? No. They're super light, so they're not going to interfere with your maneuvering when you're in EVA, which is just what you need, especially if you've got a lot of existing crafts that needs to get upgraded when you install Interstellar. This is a good way to upgrade this. Upgrade your fleet without having to relaunch everything. Whoops. That's not what I want. Store. Open. Take. Close. Come to think of it, might as well just do all four. Better safe than sorry. Don't want to risk having the receivers shut down mid-trip because of overheating. I don't think they will, but you never know. You never know. Oh, okay, I see what's going on here. It's the upgrade button. Okay, right now it's the heat pipe. That's the older model. The graphene is the newer, more efficient model. And that's the one I want. I'll get this attached again. Excellent. One more to go, and then we'll be on to the next part. He's racking up a lot of radiation. Probably have to get him back on the ground soon. He's spent a lot of time out in space. Wonder what's going, what that is. What debris is that? Oh, that's the decoupler rings. That's what they are. Let's get this upgraded before I attach it. Good. You can see it's got higher resting temperature, which means it can radiate more waste heat. Let's put this right here. And just those two. Oh, what's up with this facial expression? It seems all stressed out. I don't know what his problem is. He's doing a great job. Has this one been... Okay, that one's been upgraded. Come on. Okay. That should take care of it. Let's get back inside and take a breather. Yeah, get those radiators deployed. Whoops. Graphene is what I want. Good, good. Good. Excellent. Let's deploy these. Oh, All right, not exactly the most symmetrical configuration, but it'll do. That'll do. All right. Let's see, take a pause and